In this video, let us understand how to make payroll management. So it's a web application project demo. So here we are using ASP.NET, C Sharp and SQL Server as a backend. So we all know in every company, payroll is a big role. So payroll is very, very important. So therefore, you have to make such a way that it should work properly and every employee get the project. If you choose a payroll, it's a good idea because the scope is good, the scope is very wide. So it is always better to choose payroll management and then can do this particular project. First, let us understand what are the things we need to add up in the project. Fine. So if you're doing any CS course, there is a computer science course and you need to do a project. So you need to select the topic. So I think online payroll management is one such topic which you can choose and you can prove that this is a good project. Because when you talk about the scope is very wide. Because every company requires a payroll management and also job wise. So therefore, if you complete this whole project and you prove that this whole thing is working fine, there is a good chance to get the good job because in every company, they record their own way of doing the payroll. So therefore, someone has to manage, someone has to write the complete program. So therefore, the chances are very good. But so let's come back and then let's discuss about the project. So here you can have a two module. One is admin module. So then that is the employee module. So in admin module, so you can log in, you can go to main page and here you can write the employee details. Then after that, we can enter the attendance, how much attendance is code. Then you can generate the salary. Then you can view the salary. On the other side, employee can log in. So you can go to main page. There you can apply for the leave. So there's a paid leave. Then you can see the salary, view salary, and also you can communicate with the admin. So therefore you can have a send message, then there is a view message. So this is the communication. So here also you can have a send message and then view message. So these are things generally is required in order to make an online project. So this will demonstrate you like how the whole concept works. So once you know this, then easy for you to write this project. You can use any language like online languages like JSP, R, PHP or Python to write this project. So if you have any project requirement or customized software requirement for your business, please contact us. Now let's look at the demo. So here we open the Visual Studio. So you can see that this is the admin main page. So here these are the options are provided. Qualification, corresponding list, designation, corresponding list, employee details. This is important. We can enter all the employee details here and we can see the list here and we can enter the basic salary. What is the basic salary for each employee? Corresponding list. Then attendance we need to enter. We can see the list. Then you can generate the salary. We can see the list. Then send message and view message. On the other side, again, employee main. So here you can apply for leave, leave list, salary list, change password, send message, view message. These are things provided. And you can see the database here. This, if expand, you can see the tables. These are the tables which are using in this particular project. Let's run the project. Fine. So here you can see the main page. So fine. So this is the main page. And from here we can get into the site. So then you can go to admin page. Later it's correct. Right. So here what happens? So this is a qualification and corresponding list. So this is general degree. So you want to make it as like no MCA, you can write MCA. And then you need to expand and you need to write it over there. So and if you go to list, there what are the entry we done? So it will come over here. So next, same thing, designation, lecturer, reader. So particularly for college, okay, suitable. There we have lecturers and the readers. So then you want to enter principal and all like. So if you go to list, so you already have employee 1, employee 1001, P1, T1, E1, all the employees are there. So for more employees, you have to go to employee detail and then you have to enter the data here. Then here is a basic salary. For each employee, what is basic, DA, HRA, all we need to calculate. So if you enter the basic, then rest of the things will be calculated automatically because you have a formula here. So therefore all the values will be get filled. Right. So next is attendance entry. So here you can see attendance entry January and E1. We can check paid leaves 4, unpaid leaves 0. So total attendance. So he attended 26 days. Save. So same way, employee 1, 30 days. But like that, you need to generate all the employee salaries. So if you go to lists, so what are the salaries are generated, we could be able to see here. Okay, first you need to go to generate salary. So we need to enter the attendance for everyone. Then you have to go to list. So here you can see that employee 1 and employee 2, that salary is generated. So if you don't enter anything, then 0 will come. So but you can enter again, you can generate. That will be generated. Now we can log in as the employee and then check it out whether you can see the salary or not. So employee, so E1, so right. So here you can see that salary list. So here you can see the employee salary, that is E1 generated here. So that list will come over there. So we can also send message to the other employee. For example, you want to send the employee 1 regarding salary. I got salary. Fine. So if they send the message, they can able to view it over there here. So you can send the value, message to the admin also. From the admin also, if you get the message, you can get the message here. So these are things which are provided here. So in the payroll management, so it's working fine. So this is the concept we need to cover in a payroll. So once you get an idea, so probably you try to improve this, or first you need to complete this. So once it's over, then it probably you can improve the project. Fine. So if you think to say something to us, please write it in the comment box. Let me know what you're thinking. So we have many videos in our channel. So you please go to iBliss tutorials and videos. There you can browse. We can get a lot of videos, and also you can learn like how to make the projects. So we have provided all the things step by step. So please watch.